गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम हियर विद यू विद माय एपिसोड नंबर 4 ऑफ फिजिक्स क्लास 10th चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो टुडे दिस इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद माय प्रीवियस एपिसोड नंबर 3. टुडे आई विल डिस्क्राइब अबाउट द resistance. So what is resistance? Resistance is the property of a conductor by the virtue of which it opposes or resists the flow of charges. And we know that the flow of charges produces the electric current. That means resistance opposes or resists the flow of electric current. The SI unit of resistance is ohm, and as we know from the Ohm's law that V is equal to IR or R is equal to V upon I. Or we can say 1 ohm, the unit of resistance is ohm, the unit of potential difference V is volts, and the unit of current is ampere. So 1 ohm is equal to 1 volt upon 1 ampere. So how do we define the 1 ohm resistance? So when there is a voltage across the ends of the conductor is 1 volt and the current flowing through the conductor is 1 ampere, then the resistance produced is said to be 1 ohm. So this is the definition of 1 ohm resistance. Now the next point comes, this is the mechanism of the resistance. And in my previous episodes, I have told you about the mechanism of the resistance in the detail. So just in a brief, I will tell you the mechanism again. For that, we consider a conductor. Suppose this is a conductor. And we know that every matter is made up of atoms or molecules. So these are the atoms present in the conductor, and some few electrons are also indicated here, which are moving in the zigzag direction. So now how the resistance is produced? So since these free electrons are moving in a zigzag direction, so at this time there is no current. And when we connect this conductor with a cell or a battery, then what happens? The electrons from the negative terminal starts moving towards the conductor. And when these electrons enter into the conductor, it collides with the atoms and free electrons present in the conductor. So due to this collision between the atoms of the conductor and the electron coming from the negative terminal of the battery, a frictional force is developed between them. And this frictional force is responsible for the resistance. And this frictional force causes the resistance. And this resistance opposes or resists the flow of the charges, or we can say flow of the electric current. Now, coming to the next point, the factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends.
Now I will tell you what are the factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends. So there are four factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends, and the one is length of the conductor. Second is the area of cross section of conductor. Third is the nature of the material, and the fourth is the temperature. So these are the four factors on which the resistance depends. Now I will take it one by one, the length of the conductor. So this resistance is denoted by R, and this resistance is directly proportional to the L, that is the length of the conductor. If we increase the length of the conductor, the resistance will increase, and if we decrease the length of the conductor, the resistance will decrease. And second is, resistance is proportional to the 1 upon area of cross section. So if we increase the area of cross section of the conductor, the resistance will decrease. And if we decrease the area of cross section of the conductor, the resistance will increase. So this is equation first, and this is equation 2. Now the third one is the nature of the material. The resistance also depends upon the nature of the material. Suppose it is made up of copper, there will be the atoms of the copper, and if it is made up of aluminium, there will be the atoms of the aluminium. So they have the different resistance. Now the fourth one is temperature. If we increase the temperature of the conductor, the resistance will increase. So resistance will also be directly proportional to temperature. If we increase the temperature, the resistance will increase. So now coming to the point, definition of specific resistance or resistivity, rho. So what is specific resistance or resistivity? We know that R is directly proportional to L, R is directly proportional to 1 upon A. So this is equation first and this is equation second. On combining these equation number 1 and 2, what we get? R will be proportional to L upon A. So now this is a sign of proportionality, and it is a principle that if we remove the sign of proportionality, we have to put a constant. So R is equal to, when we remove this sign of proportionality, this R is equal to rho L upon A, and this rho is known as the specific resistance or resistivity. So this is a specific resistance or resistivity, and the unit of this resistivity is, we can find out from here, rho is equal to R A upon L, and this is equal to R into area. We can write L into L divided by L, so L will cancel out here, so this will be R into L, and the unit of R, that is resistance, is ohm, and the unit of length is meter. So the unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Now what is the definition of this specific resistance or resistivity? We can get it from here. Since we know that R is equal to rho L upon A, or rho is equal to R A upon L. R A upon L. So if L is equal to 1 meter and A is equal to 1 meter square, then rho is equal to R. So the specific resistance or the resistivity will be equal to the resistance when the length of the conductor is 1 meter and the area of cross section is 1 meter square. Now coming to the, and this specific, it is the, this specific resistance or resistivity is the characteristic property of the material. So this is the resistivity is the property of the material, and resistance is the property of the conductor. This is the basic difference. Now coming to the next point, this uses of different materials. So there are so many materials, insulators, semiconductors. Now if we are using this copper and aluminium, they are used for electric wiring. The second one, nichrome. What is nichrome? Nichrome is a alloy of nickel, chromium, manganese and iron. So this nichrome is a alloy of nickel, chromium, manganese and iron. And this nichrome is used for heaters and electric iron. So how this serves the purpose, solves the purpose? Because it is this alloy of nickel, chromium, manganese and iron, that is nichrome, is having very high resistivity. And that's why we are using in the heater and electric iron. It is also having very high melting point. Now the next is tungsten. This is used for the filament of electric bulbs. And this tungsten is also having the high resistivity and high melting point. And the fourth one is insulators. Insulators are used to protect from the electric shock, because insulators are those substances which do not allow the electric current to pass through them. That's why insulators are used to protect from the electric shock. Now coming to the next point, that is a system of resistance. So in the practical applications, we are using two or more than two resistance to make a circuit, and this can be done by two ways, that is in series and in parallel. Now in series, the resistance are connected in series like this. Suppose this is a circuit and one resistance, second resistance and the third resistance. This is R1, R2, R3 and this is connected with a circuit. So this is a series circuit. Now in parallel, if we are using the three resistance R1, R2, R3, so these are connected in such a way that a battery is connected with the three resistance R1, R2, R3 and they are connected in this manner. So this is the parallel combination of the resistance. Now if we find out the equivalent resistance of the series combination of the resistance, so how we will find out the equivalent resistance? Now the next point is the equivalent resistance of the series combination of the resistance. As shown in the figure, there are three resistance R1, R2 and R3, and these are connected in series, and we have connected these resistance with a battery of 12 volt, and there is a plug key and this is an ammeter. So ammeter is always connected in series, so we have connected here. The positive terminal of the ammeter is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, and negative terminal of the ammeter is connected with the negative terminal of the battery, and voltmeter is connected over here. And we know that the voltmeter is always connected in parallel, so we have connected over here. This is a parallel connection of the voltmeter. The positive terminal of the voltmeter is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, and the negative terminal is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. So now we see that in case of this series combination, the important thing is that the current is coming from here, this positive terminal, to the negative terminal. And suppose I is the current which is coming from this battery. So now I is the current which is coming from the battery, and in this parallel connection of the resistance, the same current I will flow from through the resistance R1, and I will flow through the R2 and R3. So in parallel connection, combination of the resistance, the same current will flow through all the resistances when they are connected in series. But the voltage across the resistance R1 will be different. The voltage across the resistance R1 will be V1, the voltage across the resistance R2 will be V2, and the voltage across the resistance R3 will be V3. So now, as we know that V is equal to IR, that is Ohm's law, and V is equal to IR. So now we can see over here that V is the total voltage that is equal to the voltage across R1, V1, voltage across R2, V2, or voltage across R3, V3. So now if we calculate V1, V2, V3 over here, so V is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3, and V is equal to IR. So if I is taken as common, then this will be R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this I will cancel out here, and the final result will be R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is the final result when the resistance are connected in series. So the equivalent resistance of the series combination of the resistances R1, R2, R3 is equal to capital R, and this R is the equivalent resistance, and R1, R2, R3 are the three resistances which are connected in series. Now the disadvantage of series circuits in domestic wiring. In domestic wiring, what are the disadvantages of series connections? So first is major disadvantage of series circuit is that when one device fails, the circuit is broken and all other device stop working. So now what is the disadvantage? Suppose this circuit fails. Now the next point is equivalent resistance of parallel combination of resistance. So now if we are connecting the resistance R1, R2, R3 in parallel, then to find out the equivalent resistance, what will be the calculation? Now as shown in figure, this R1 is the resistance, R2, R3, these are the three resistances which are connected in parallel as shown in figure. Now it is connected through the, these two ends are connected through the voltage which is also in parallel, because the voltmeter is always connected in parallel in the circuit, and this is connected with a battery and a plug key and ammeter. Ammeter is used to measure the current. Now suppose I current is flowing through the battery and it is coming to over here, and it will be divided into three parts. This I1 is the current flowing through R1, I2 is the current flowing through resistance R2, and I3 is the current flowing through the resistance R3. And in this parallel connection, the important thing is that the voltage across the system will be same in the voltage across resistance R1, R2 and R3. So V is the voltage across resistance R1, V is the voltage across resistance R2, and V is the voltage across resistance R3. Now to find out the equivalent resistance, we know that V is equal to IR. This is Ohm's law, and V upon R is equal to I. Now as from the parallel combination of the circuit, this I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. As shown in figure, this I current is coming, which is divided into three parts, I1, I2, I3, and the outgoing current is also I. So now I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now from this Ohm's law, I is equal to V upon R. So we can write it right here as I is equal to V upon R is equal to V upon R1 plus V upon R2 plus V upon R3. So V upon R is equal to we have taken as a common, so this will come under bracket, 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3, and we will cancel out over here, and we get 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. So this R is the equivalent resistance. So to find out the equivalent resistance of parallel combination of the resistance, the result will be 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Now the next point is the advantage of parallel circuits in domestic wiring. Advantage of parallel circuits in domestic wiring. So there are four advantages of parallel circuits used in the domestic wiring. So now one question arises over here, why we use the parallel
connection or parallel resistance in domestic wiring. So the reason behind this is, a parallel combination provides the same potential difference across each electrical appliances, but different values of current. In parallel connection, the voltage across each resistance will be same, and the current across each resistance will be different. So the next advantage is, electrical devices have different resistance, so they may current of widely different values of to operate properly. And the third one is, parallel combination of the resistance in circuits divides the current as per the demand. And the next one is, if one of the device fails to work, then a parallel combination keeps on working the other appliances. If one of the appliances fails to work, then the other appliances keeps on working as shown in the figure. This is in the case of parallel combination. And the final is, in parallel circuits, the electrical appliances has its own switch, hence it can be turned on or turned off independently as per the need.